I seem to overhear a retort. No one, of course, is deprived of his civil rights at Athens unjustly. My answer is that there are some who are unjustly deprived of their civil rights, though the cases are certainly rare. But it will take more than a few to attack the democracy at Athens, since you may take it as an established fact. It is not the man who has lost his civil rights justly that takes the matter to heart, but the victims, if any, of injustice. But how in the world can anyone imagine that many are in a state of civil disability at Athens, where the people and the holders of office are one and the same? It is from iniquitous exercise of office, from iniquity exhibited either in speech or action, and the like circumstances, that citizens are punished with deprivation of civil rights in Athens. Due reflection on these matters will serve to dispel the notion that there is any danger at Athens from persons visited with disenfranchisement. End of The Polity of the Athenians by Xenophon. The Polity of the Lacedaemonians by Xenophon, translated by H. G. Dakins. Parts 1 through 7. Part 1. I recall the astonishment with which I first noted the unique position of Sparta amongst the states of Hellas, the relatively sparse population, and at the same time the extraordinary power and prestige of the community. I was puzzled to account for the fact. It was only when I came to consider the peculiar institutions of the Spartans that my wonderment ceased. Or rather, it is transferred to the legislator who gave them those laws, obedience to which has been the secret of their prosperity.